चार्ज नहीं गए। A very good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the final. It has been a 16-man competition that has been organized here where we are at hashtag bar and restaurant in Nansana near Kampala. The two protagonists at the final are the two players whom you would say are maybe were two of the favorites. It is Rashid Wagaba, Dog City. It is Ibrahim Kanja, the Real Machine. And it is two games played and it is one game apiece. Ibrahim Kayanja 1, Rashid Wagaba 1, race to 6. I'm in the meantime just hoping that the sound is audible enough. I'm having to apply a noise filtering microphone in order to keep the video and the page safe from lots of copyrighted music in the background. Two players who like to go for the game, two players who like to attack with skill, two players who don't believe that each of them is better than the other, two players who had a money match about 10 days ago. A race to 16 for $1,200. That one was won by Dog City. If I'm not mistaken, I think it was 16-12 at Amigos in Kampala. Chance for the Real Machine to redeem himself, to pay revenge to Dog City, to respond to fire with fire, to respond to victory with victory. In the semi-finals, Ibrahim Kanja defeated Alan Nsubuga for Dog City. He defeated a lady, the only lady who participated, but then played up to the semi-finals. If 5-2 the score was, while for Ibrahim Kanja 5-0 the score was. Those two losers, Rashid Amotesi and Alan Subuga, are playing out a third place match on the other table, and we shall be getting updates from that one as well. For this one you're watching, it's still 1-1 between the Real Machine and the Dog in the City. And the Dog City is maybe poised to go 2-1 down because he's up against an opponent who is today playing so well. If you had watched that performance in the semi-final, but look at that white ball. Wow. I thought he would make a little backspin. The guy is so confident. Maybe I would even say he's arrogant. There we go. Ibrahim Kanja 2, Rashid Wagaba 1. The third place match has been made a short rest to 3, and Rashid Amotesi has come third after defeating Alan Nsoboga 3-1. And this one is the final you're watching, a short rest to 6 compared to some of the finals we play. Most of them are races to 9, sometimes at least 7. This time it is 6, maybe because of the lesser number of players who participated. Nonetheless, we have a final. Guys, I need some predictions in the comment section. Only 3 games have been played. Only a 2-1 lead for Ibrahim Kanja, the Real Machine. Talkative guy, he likes to talk himself up, likes to motivate himself before and after his games. He entertains on table, but he also entertains off table. Cute Pixels Photography, Francis Mukwekwe. Yes, maybe come to the comment section, maybe better off inbox where we normally have our chats, and we can jointly prepare and confirm that Maluva tour. Francis, you think that Ibrahim Kanja will win 6-3? Just in case it doesn't happen, I'll screenshot your comment and then post it on its own. So Sikwe, you think Kanja will win? Sami K, you also think Mosiram will win? It's his other nickname, by the way. Valeria Crush, of course, supporting Ibra like you normally do. So Sikwe, thank you for watching. Justice Mhando, you don't think Dog City will win? Okay. Managed by the Advanced Talent Agency, Dog City. If he wins this match, it will be the first comp he is winning in 10 weeks. In terms of these 10 weeks, the last 10 weeks, in terms of comps, they have been dominated mostly by Caesar and Mansour and Hazard. and Ibrahim Kayanja, by the way, of late, especially the month of May. The time when Cesar was in the country, he was without doubt the best player in the country. He won 3 comps, lost 1 final, and a semi-final out of 5 tournaments he played. Edmond Batema, you think Lake City is winning this one 6-5? Okay. Okotawe. Okay, you say Malova is underdog. Okay, Stanley Mbudia. You think Kayanja will win this one? Valeria is always in the comment section supporting Kayanja. Eh? He's shooting well, he's confident. Ibrahim Kayanja has been playing better in the tournament compared to his opponent, but a final is a final. It's not yet even 2 weeks since Dog City beat Kayanja in that money match at Amigos in Kampala. It will be some good revenge for the real machine if he wins this one. And I think he's going 3-1 down. I mean 3-1 up. The real machine in the lead against the dog in the city. This tournament came up a little bit later, by the way, because at the same venue, a good representation of Uganda's elite players were forming a players union. Yes, that is some political news from the game. Omar Gazat, you think Dog City will win? Victor Mlaudzi, you think Kayanja will win by 6-5? You are watching from Lira in Northern Uganda. Kamugisha Daniel, thank you. And welcome to the stream. Zari Wamangule, thank you for watching. Gets to put one red on the break. A good split of the balls. I think he will go for the yellows. Seven yellows, all of them placed in perfect space. And a relatively good black. With Ibrahim Kayanja playing in this vein of form, any player can fall. Nowadays, hugely respected, by the way, all over the continent, especially with the skill with which Ibrahim Kayanja plays this game. Became a phenomenal player around 2021, when he decided just to play all against all of then Uganda's best players in money matches, winning majority of them, and then won selection trials to the Uganda national team and represented Uganda at the All Africa Pool Championships at the OYDC in Zambia in 2022, where he was Uganda's better performing player, reaching the semi-finals after losing out to eventual first runner-up South Africa's Rivaldo Givens. And since then he has made a claim to himself being one of Uganda's better players, and indeed he has been. he needs one big shot here to go for one up. I think he's now an overwhelming favorite to win this final, to win this tournament. He will surely be sinking this black in, which he does, and does so comfortably, and now leads 4-1. It seems it's not Dog City's day. Not when your opponent is shooting as good as that. Not when you are 4-1 down is when you foul on the break. Rashida is just whispering to me that after this performance from Mosiram Ibrahim Kayanja, which seems will end in victory, she says a rematch of the money match these two guys had about 10 days ago is loading any time soon. It's about to become two straight clearances with one visit, and that is a guy in form. In the end, he has complicated something that seemed so easy. I like to say that the difference between winning and losing when it is players of this level is sometimes very, very, very minute. He now has to play off the rail and misses and fouls. Thank you guys for watching. Apologies, today we have only watched 3 matches in a comp like this one. 16 participants. Masake Sona, a guy called Charles, then Dog City, then Fred, Ibazube, then Jose, then Mark, then Bob Katerega, Faruk, Mutumba, Alan, Subga, Lutaya, Geoffrey, a guy called Wacha, Ibrahim Makayanja, Asiku Jackson, the talented young man, as well as Innocent Tumashabe. You're looking at the players who have performed best, the top 2. One of them is up on the black, Ibrahim Kayanja. The other is having 4 reds and a chance maybe for 2 shots if Ibrahim Kayanja misses the black. And yes, he does miss the black. And what about that for maybe a game winning shot? Sometimes these guys really know how to entertain, and entertain when the time is the right thing. Very determined man, about to steal, I will say steal a game that was never ever meant for him, and yet he pulls another back. Ibrahim Kayanja 4, Rashid Wagaba 2, race to 6. Meaning that a total of 5 games is left. If we are to have a decider of the 5, the real machine needs 2 and Dog City 4. Seems that the real machine, as this guy proclaimed himself, maybe is about to redeem himself, but maybe not. And I want to think that this ongoing frame is so decisive, maybe so determinant for Ibrahim Kayanja, if he wins it, to extend his lead to 5-2 and try to force his opponent to win 4 straight if he's to win the match. But for Dog City to pull one back and bring himself within 1 game of his opponent. We're at hashtag. Then it normally holds monthly comps. That comp that was held here was won by the monthly ones. It was won by Abubakar Nakabale Pacquiao. He defeated Ibrahim Kayanja in the final. 1 month prior, Hazard defeated Caesar in the final. Thank you. We need about two big shots here. A coward player would simply play. Maybe a careful player, not a coward player, would play not to pot. But this guy is not one of those coward players. Sometimes these boys are too brave that you think it is too risky, their approach to the game. Coming up on Tuesday, weekly comp that normally happens at Kamo Chapel Center, 32 man comp. But maybe coming up in the next 3 minutes could be Ibrahim Kayanja going 5-2 up. All right, how about that one? For a redemption shot. We'll need top spin, white ball following the red, bouncing off the rail, then traveling the entire length of the table, maybe backspin, bouncing off its two rails, even better. Not short on skill. Mentally tough guy. Has pulled two games back, two unexpected frames back. He's now within one frame of his opponent. Ibrahim Kayanja 4, Rashid Wagaba 3, rests to 6. Dog City gets a round of applause for this one. I'm realizing he has the lion's share of the fans here. and he's going to equalize. Four, rest to six. It is one of those games when you just watch it and you think the race is not even long enough. You want these guys to keep entertaining you more and more and more. And if the race is coming close to its end, the guy who started in the lead and then gave out the lead has regained his lead. Ibrahim Kayanja 5, Rashid Wagaba 4. Rest to 6. Out of 2 games remaining, Dog City needs to win both or else succumb to second position. Majority of you were predicting that Ibrahim Kayanja will win, and you thought it would be 6-5. Those of you are still on track. Francis Mukwekwe, a very renowned name in African pool, said it will be 6-3. The match is not yet done, but his prediction is already the worst of all. Sorry, Francis. Well supported guy, Dog City. When he does magic, he gets the applause. He's not as social in real life as Ibrahim Kayanja, but somehow fans love him. One of those players whose performance is attributed just on personal merit. Thank you. He now must spot. Shims Kapela Chunga, your prediction is also officially wrong and you're asking your prediction to rest in peace. Okay. That is a miss by Dog City, which could make him miss the victory altogether. Thank you for watching. Spina Kenny. Betty Tabitha, you say you are telling Dog City that you're single. Betty, Dog City is not single, he has a girlfriend. And when his girlfriend is playing, I will stream her game, then I'll tell you who they are. Emmanuel Alina, it is rest to six, so Ibrahim Kanja makes this clearance. That will be it for the day. Enoch at Legang, you're telling me of the big comp in Cape Town. Kindly tell me, kindly give me the details, inbox, and the poster and everything. The comp in Cape Town, which I was thinking of, was the one that was won around 10 days ago by Aiden. But what a miss. Maybe we are having a decider in the next 1 minute. Also, as long as Dog City makes this clearance, we need white ball to have a big backspin bouncing off the rail. Find the red, I'm not so sure he can see it in full. Seems to insinuate that the bounce of the cushion is not good enough. Seems to blame his shortcoming on the table. Just finds his red. Ibrahim Kanja was hiding the white but did not hide it well enough. Dog City can see the red ball clearly, in my opinion. Just the way he played the white ball after bouncing off the rail. Like they normally say, too much English on it for it to move to that direction and not the opposite. If he sinks this one in, we have a decider. And there we go, Ibrahim Kanja 5, Rashid Wakaba 5, rest to 6, decider. Just tell the viewers your name and who you think is winning this tournament, this game, this decider.
My name is Nyanzi. This decider can be won by Dog.
You think Dog City? Why?
He's
the one who has been coming from behind.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
I get it. He shares my view. in the deciders, normally the guy who is coming from behind is the guy with the psychological advantage. But it is Ibrahim Kanja's turn on the table. He's playing yellows. Yes, these guys respect decisive games. Ibrahim Kanja, in his normal element, will put that yellow ball. In a decider, he decides not to. Some very ambitious shooting here. Dog City aimed to put his red off his opponent's yellow. In the end, he misses. Thank you, Ishmael Banda. You're watching from Malawi. Aban DJ, thank you for watching. Kuselo Nkukuma. You say Ibrahim Sajemba is the truth. The truth is Hazard's nickname. Eh? Don't steal it. Chigume Amos, rest to six. Bad red game, I will say. Dog City will want to bank that red ball to this center pocket where he's standing. Mindful of the white ball. He finds the bank. Maybe he can try out another bank. The red ball crosses to the yellow, crosses to the white ball. To the corner pocket near where he's standing now. Why not? But if he misses, maybe the end result, your guess is as good as mine. Still young men, both of them, but very experienced. Combined total of close to 20 years between them, both of them starting to play as very young teenagers, now in early 20s. For Ibrahim Kanja, coming to mid-20s, Dog City should be around 23. He'll need all the experience and expertise he used to win the 2017 Senior Pool League in Uganda with the Captain Knight Pool Club. He'll need the expertise he used to win 7 weekly comps and the single venue tournaments in 2023 just to win this one game. He has a sight of only one of his reds, clearly. The red ball to the top right corner pocket. He can probably play it off the rail of the cushion, but most probably he will not be potting. to just joining the stream, you are watching the closing stages of a 16-man competition that has been going on for the last maybe 5 hours here at Hashtag Bar and Restaurant in Nansana. Finals between Rashid Wagaba and the Dog City Racing to 6, and we are having a decider. Big shots, big miss. Thank you for watching, my friend Motesi Esther Anthony Egesa. One big shot, he is away by Mkayanja, as long as he rolls that white ball, putting yellow ball to the top right corner pocket, having white ball to move a quarter of the length of the table, putting black ball to the center pocket on the left, maybe the corner pocket, bottom left. Decides to go for the corner pocket, will have to be on target, and is on target, and wins. You can count. Maybe in the last 4 weeks, maybe it is now 5 weekly tournaments for Ibrahim Mkayanja, and the majority of the other tournaments he has been reaching at least the prize bracket. He wins another, this time he gets the better of Dog City in the final. Thank you for being a lovely audience. Result: Ibrahim Mkayanja 6, Rashid Wagaba 5.
Yes, Mkayanja Ibra. Ladies and gentlemen, hi, how are you? Hope you are doing well. Mkayanja Ibra, aka Islam. Yeah, we appreciate and we need you, we always need you to support us. Yeah, thanks for supporting us, thanks for supporting Pool Table and supporting Break and Finish. Yeah, and the machine Mkayanja Ibra, thanks my fans for supporting me than today. Yeah, thanks for my, and I'm looking for management, that is it. All the best, thanks, next time later.
Zimbabwe number one Maluva wants to play a race with you. What do you have to tell him, Maluva?
Available for Maluva anytime, any stake. I'm available for him. We shall be waiting for him in Uganda. And we are waiting for him for his coming. Safe journey, Maluva, to Uganda. Yeah, we are ready for you, sir. And the machine, the real machine is ready for you. Yeah,
Maluva, the real machine, welcomes you to Uganda and wishes you a safe journey, but says he wants to have a race with you. Thank you, for ladies and gentlemen, for being a lovely audience. I wish you a good night and God bless.